Leaders such as yourself know that it's not what you say, but how you say it that matters. If you want to learn the other missing two-thirds of this statement, watch this video. So it's obvious that there are, it's obvious, let me put this another way. It's obvious, that statement is obvious, but so also are virtually every aspect of running a business well, becoming a great company, and yet few ever attain greatness and fewer still sustain such greatness. So obvious doesn't necessarily mean that people have found an effective way to execute on that. So if you learn anything from this video that's valuable, please share, like, subscribe, or follow these videos. Thanks. This topic actually reminds me of some of my favorite Simpsons episodes, which are the Halloween episodes. So in the Treehouse of Horrors, Lisa discovers this cookbook when there are guests on an alien spacecraft, and it's called How to Cook Humans. No matter how you say that, this is an example of the what. No matter how you say that, it'll come across poorly, provided you're human. If you're a human on the spaceship and you see that book, it, no matter how they say it, How to Cook Humans, it still sounds like it's probably bad news. So what really does matter? But then the alien goes, no, there's some dust on here. And he blows off the dust. And the title changes to say How to Cook for Humans. One small word added. And again, this changes all aspects of the meaning of the message, right? But Lisa goes, no, wait, there's still more space dust. So she blows it off to reveal the title as How to Cook 40 Humans. How to Cook 40 Humans. Again, it goes in a bad direction for all humans who might be guests of aliens. Then the alien goes, wait, there's still more space dust on here. Blows off the dust to recover the entire title, to uncover the entire title of the book, which is How to Cook for 40 Humans. I think this is a brilliant and funny episode. Matt Groening and his staff are, in my mind, very intellectual in that they get human nature and can convey it, and clearly words matter to what they do. And so why this is so brilliant, and it also illustrates, again, something that's obvious, and it's the truth that what you say and why you say it matters equally or even perhaps more than how you say it. You can't ignore that. I think what people have lost the point of is like, oh, well, everybody knows that what you say is important, so let's ignore that now. You can't really ignore that. So if you think of it this way, a hard truth poorly expressed out of love and a genuine desire to help someone is a whole different animal than the same words exactly expressed with less than noble intent, reasons, or why. So it's just not as simple as one or the other. It is what you say, how you say it, and it's also why you say it. So let me give you an example of this. This is an actual situation that happened to me, and I really felt like the people behind their words were really didn't have my best interest at heart. Let's put it that way. So I said this neutral statement to mine and see what happened. I said, well, you know, I'm not sure this is something for me. Let me think about it. But I really wish you all the success you deserve. And if you say that without judgment, you deliver it without judgment, the how of the saying isn't like, well, I really wish you, then how is obviously going to matter. And how does matter, but it's just not the whole package. It was very telling that she became hostile. If somebody said, Tim, I really wish that you receive all the success you deserve, I would thank them sincerely. And that's easy to do when your intention is something that isn't selfish. I'm not saying I don't have my own motivations and my own self-interest in what I do, but if it didn't matter, I just go back to doing some of the other things I've done that didn't matter, and it's the reason why I'm doing what I'm doing now. So if you give somebody a neutral statement like that, it doesn't say, I wish you ill. It doesn't say, I wish you well. It says, I wish you all the success you deserve. Now, if the person saying it doesn't really think they deserve success or has less than honorable intentions, it's pretty hard for them not to take offense to that when, in fact, there's no direction, no polarity to that statement. It's a very interesting way to sort of detect somebody's intentions. So really what this comes down to is I am a massive fan of and continuous student of words chosen well. This is not an easy thing. I even tell my English students that writing is far harder than speaking. Both have their own challenges, but writing well is what my last English teacher taught me was very compelling was this is a one-way communication. You can't clarify the message. You have one chance to convey your message if it's written. So that's not the same as if you're spoken, but still the better said, the less said that will be necessary or the less necessary to say. Okay. So it's actually a real challenge to have your words land as intended and produce the best outcomes for all involved. As far as I'm concerned, that's a lifelong pursuit. And so really to do it well, it takes continuous thought, practice, and testing. So here's some sort of questions you can ask yourself when you're producing it and when you proofread it, which you should always do. I'm a little bad at that myself. Ask yourself, what am I meaning to say and which words will best accomplish it? So that's obviously the what, not the how. How should I say it? Which words should I use to maximize the probability it's received as intended so that your intent aligns with the way it's received? So that's obviously intonation, prosody, all that kind of stuff. The way you deliver it, but also it still matters what you deliver. And then the last one, and this one is connected to both of the others, but comes across more in involuntary things like micro expressions on your face and body language that you have. And that is, what is my greater reason or why for saying it, for saying this? I mean, how often have you seen that somebody says something, it's hard to read down and look at the camera. Heard something, how often have you seen or heard the benevolent intent or lack of it in someone's words? It's the words say one thing, but the tone, their body language, their micro expressions say something different. So if they don't align, perhaps in my experience, in my opinion, if your words don't match your intent, people tend to pick up on it. Not all people, but some people will, and that matters. So if your words don't match your intent, it may be better to say nothing at all. This has been Crush It Club 124, how, what, and why all matter. My name is Tim B. Green. Bye for now.